The Mi Band series from Xiaomi has been tremendously successful all around the globe. One of the main reasons for that is Xiaomi doesn't really hike up the price too much, despite adding some key features in every iteration. The fourth version of Mi Band is here and it's expected to launch in India very soon. So let's take a brief look at it and check out the new design and features. Before that, let me introduce myself. My name is Ashwin Sundar. This is Technology Jog. Kindly subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get our videos and recommendations. A huge shout out to JioZilla, our sponsor for this video. JioZilla app aims to help you keep your friends and family safe by allowing you to locate them in real time. You also get up to 2 weeks of their location history. And with all of that location data, JioZilla uses AI to detect any abnormal deviations in the route, schedule, or speed. And if there is any unusual behavior, the app alerts the emergency contact. Yes, it uses GPS, but it doesn't drain the battery too much because the app will be in sleep mode unless there is a significant change in location. So check out JioZilla to keep your family members safe. It's available on both iOS and Android. Link in the description. So here's the box. Since I bought it from China, it's full of Chinese, but here's what it says. Basically, a list of all the features the band offers. Inside the box, we have the Mi Band 4, of course, the strap is pre-installed, and then there's a proprietary charging cradle, which you can connect to a power adapter. We've got a user manual as well, which is again in Chinese. So the key change that Xiaomi has brought to the Mi Band 4 is this colored AMOLED display, which is just fantastic. It's not just about color, there's a lot more to admire about the display. One obvious thing is the increase in size. It's 0.95 inches, around 40% larger than the Mi Band 3's display. The glass they have used here is also of better quality. It's a 2.5D tempered glass with anti-fingerprint coating. The display also looks a bit sharper because of higher resolution, 240 pixels by 120 pixels. And the best thing, something that actually contributes to better experience in practical usage, is how bright it can get. It can reach up to 400 nits, which is really good for a fitness band or for an inexpensive smart band. I can clearly remember the Mi Band 3's display was nowhere near this. I mean, it was quite okay, it was usable, but after looking at this display, I don't think I can go back to the Mi Band 3. So bigger size, colors, higher resolution, much brighter. All of this together can make an impact on the battery life. But Xiaomi still claims this can last 20 days on a single charge. How is that? Well, two reasons. Number one, the Mi Band 4 uses the latest Bluetooth 5.0 technology, so it's a bit more power efficient. And number two, it uses a 22% larger battery. However, I'll have to use it for at least a month to test the battery, need to use the band with different settings. So if you're looking forward to the review, please press the bell icon. Right now, I can be judgmental about one thing. The Mi Band 4 can be used with a Mi Band 3 strap, but it cannot be charged using a Mi Band 3 charger. As it is, we all find proprietary chargers kind of annoying, so I feel something like this should have been avoided. Anyway, I feel at least 10 to 15 days battery life is guaranteed. I've been using this for the past 18 hours and the charge went down by only 3%, 4% max. Okay, let's now set it up with my Asus ZigZ. Download the Mi Fit app from the Play Store, open it, tap add device, wait for it to detect your Mi Band 4, connected, done. Now remember, the exact name of this thing is Mi Smart Band 4. So fitness is not the only thing it does well. It's got a bunch of other useful features to make your life easier. And guys, this is the most important part of the setup. The more you configure it to your needs, the better the user experience. There are a lot of settings in here. Open and see each one of them. Lift wrist to show info. We don't really need it all day because while sleeping, there might be some accidental detection which will turn on the display, which will in turn affect the battery life. So set a time period. You can set the band location, left or right wrist. Discoverable, not really required. And then we have band alerts. Alerting you about something becomes a lot easier. The band just vibrates. Everything from incoming phone calls to SMS to event reminders, alarms, and even alerts from apps that you can select here. This is the list of apps that I want notifications from. In case you're looking to make use of the alarm functionality, you need to set an alarm here inside the app to get alerted by the band. Your regular phone alarm won't vibrate the band. And since this is a color display, you can set a watch face. sort of like wallpaper plus widgets. A lot of watch faces to choose from. As far as the band goes, you can just tap to wake, you can find the activity status, your heart rate, you can even select from a list of workouts, and some of them use the GPS on your phone to track your activities. And then, like we saw earlier, notifications. You can read every single message, no matter how long it is. And you've got a lot of basic features under this section. Like if you misplaced your phone, you can tap Find Device and your phone will start ringing, as long as it's still paired to the band. So that's it. This video is just a quick roundup of the features it offers. How well do they work? How good is the battery life? Is it bright enough for outdoor usage? Is the vibrating alarm effective? These are questions that I will have to answer in my full review. And if you have any questions, feel free to post in the comment section. I'll include them as well in the review. And of course, if you liked the video, show your support, subscribe to Technology Jock, and hit the bell icon. Thanks for watching. For the moment, this is Ashwin Sundar saying goodbye. I could do this. Thanks for watching. For the moment, this is Ashwin Sundar saying goodbye.